Hey, this is SGU, and welcome back to my Angels franchise here in MLB The Show 17 on the PS4. We are in the month of June 2017, and we've got a homestand coming up. The New York Yankees in town, the Kansas City Royals in town, and then after that, we'll go on the road to New York and to Boston, and then an interleague home and home split with the Dodgers. So as I've really liked doing so far in franchise mode this year is doing the new critical situations. It kind of just helps things move along in a season much faster. We can progress this franchise faster. And so that's what we're going to do. We're going to play the critical situations. And one has popped up here. We've already had a perfect game this year and maybe on the verge of another one. Perfect through six. But Schumacher's not going to make it any farther than that because the very first batter that I get control of or against, it is Jacoby Ellsbury hitting a double off the wall. So much for any attempt at a perfect game tonight. I guess one in one season is more than you can ask for. Garrett Richards getting that for us. But here, this one's going to go by the wayside. Well, at least it stayed in the park in this very close 1-0 game. We got to try to keep it at that with two outs. Schumacher's going to get the strikeout, and the inning is over. So nice recovery right there. And he is still cruising along with that 1-0 lead. Now, we came into this with a very low pitch count, considering we're into the seventh inning already. So he has a very real chance, now that he's lost the perfect game, to still continue through and get the complete game shutout. So into the eighth and one out. This is going to be a strikeout of Aaron Judge, chasing that one in the dirt. And he gets a very potentially dangerous hitter out right there. Aaron Judge retired. Now we just need to get out of this eighth inning with two outs. And this one is hit down the third baseline. Nice backhanded play. Doesn't run particularly fast, and that's good because he has the chance to throw him out. So still 1-0 as we go into the ninth now. Yankees struggling to find just that one run they need to tie. What a pitcher's duel this has been. One out in the ninth. And this is going to be down the left field line, and it's caught. Ooh, boy. Down there where you got the short wall. A little bit of butterflies in the stomach there. I was thinking maybe he gave up a solo home run, but now that's not even to the warning track. So luckily, that is tracked down by Maben. And with a 1-2 count and two outs, Ellsbury again. Oh, man, this time he's going to left. Same result. He's going to have a double. So Jacoby Ellsbury really the only one figuring things out in this game for the Yankees. Take a look at the replay as once again the Yankees have a runner in scoring position. Just going to go opposite field with this, and it slices towards the line away from the left fielder and off the fence. And by the time they get this in, he's in scoring position. And that is going to be the end of the run here. He's just one out short of the complete game shutout, but Socha is coming to get the baseball and bringing in his closer. So very close, but not quite able to shut it down. Hopefully Bedrosian can do the trick. This ball to third base, the throw on over to first, and the Angels get the 1-0 victory. It is a shutout and a win in the books for the Angels. So we'll definitely take that and move forward as we remain in first place in the American League West. As we didn't have a whole lot of offense on this day, five hits gets us one run, and that's all we needed in this one. So we've won three games in a row now, and we've got another critical situation coming up here. If the chance for Mike Trout to hit for the cycle, he already has the home run, the double, and the single. Yeah, he needs a triple, so we're asking for quite a lot here, but you never know. If he hits it in the gap, he's got the speed to get three bags. So let's give it a chance here. We're down 8-6. Hey, if he hits one in the seats here, I wouldn't mind either, but he strikes out, unfortunately, and looks like we may not win this game now. Yankees going to take it, ending our three-game winning streak. Mike Trout has a very nice game, but finishes a triple short of pulling off the cycle, so we weren't able to pull that milestone, and we lose the ball game. Trout 3-for-4, though, with 3 RBI. Great game and a great first half for him. So we check the standings, and we've got a nice, comfortable lead at this point over the Mariners. And we are taking on Kansas City now, another critical situation. In this spot, we're down by a run. We got Mike Trout 2-for-3 in this game, but we're down 2-1 in the ninth, and that solidly hit it right at the first baseman. Ah, that clears over him, and it's extra bases into the right field corner. Trout, just a little frustrated he couldn't get a hit out of that as he squared up the baseball nicely. But he's out. Cole Calhoun with two outs. 0-1 count. Bounces up the middle. Several bounces there and a nice play with the second baseman, but no chance to throw him out after that many hops. So the game is extended at least another batter, trying to decide whether to pinch run for Calhoun here. We're going to get Cameron Maben off the bench, stretched out, and hopefully with the ball hit into the gap, he can score the game-tying run. Escobar is going to hit this ball in the air, and unfortunately, that is caught by the second baseman, ending the ball game. So no rally right here for the Angels in the ninth. The Royals claim the victory on the road here in Anaheim. So you see the line score right there. Hosmer 2-for-4 with an RBI and a double. So we win the next game and the one after that. And a chance to take this series 3-1. But we're going to have to do it here in a 1-1 score, entering the game in a critical spot. Albert Pujols at the plate. Yeah, we saw his 600th homer earlier in this series. Can he homer here? No, he pops this up. Salvador Perez waiting for this to come down, calling it, and makes the catch. So Pujols, very anticlimactic at bat right there. No drama whatsoever. After him, you got CJ Cron, and he's doing the exact same thing. Pop up. And it's Perez again, waiting and making the catch. This just not working out in this inning. We remain 1-1. Let's go into the top of the 10th now, and you got a bunt attempt. Charging, throwing, and it's in time to get the out. Nice try right there, trying to catch them napping, but that's a nice defensive play at third base. Later in the inning, already a runner on. That is through to center field for a hit. Now you got runners at first and second, and the Royals mounting something in the top of the 10th, and that pitch, gets away from the catcher just enough for both runners to advance. Now it's second and third, and it got a little bit of trouble here. This ball is going to be hit to center field. Come on, make the catch. There we go. That is not Trout in center field. That is Ben Revere today as Trout gets the day off. Calhoun hits this one to right and over the right fielder's head. Going to go to the fence, and he's going to hustle the second base. Angels have the winning run in scoring position. Can they bring him around? Well, let's take a look at the replay first, as this was a line drive. You see a leaping attempt there, but no way to cut that off as it was hit too hard. So getting that run home, can we do it with two outs? No, they're going to get out of the inning. We will play on into the 11th here, still tied at one apiece. The Royals now in the top of the 11th. This one is hammered into the gap in left center field to the fence. This should be extra bases. However, a quick play in by Revere. Nah, you got no chance to get him at second. Royals once again in business. Now they're going to lay a bunt down. Third baseline should be an out, except what are we waiting for? The throw delayed, and then he's safe. What happened? Well, you see, for some reason, Pujols also charged for the bunt. He's got to get back to the base, doesn't do so in time, and he's safe. I'm sure a lot of you are saying, don't play Pujols at first base. Hey, I get you loud and clear. Now, a suicide squeeze attempt, and he's out. He missed the bunt. So we set them up in perfect position to score a run, then they run themselves right out of it. Yes, it's a high degree of difficulty here, at least that it is risk and reward. If you lay the bunt down, you get the run, but he misses it. He cannot miss the bunt right there. So now a new chance to maybe get ourselves out of this, except Pujols. Oh, man, he's had a rough inning there at first base, proving to be a liability. Yeah, maybe we should just be DHing him. I'm not sure why he's in my default lineup as first baseman on certain days anyway. But, he kind of showing why maybe he shouldn't be right there. That is kind of brutal. We have to have that play. Royals score the go-ahead run. It's now 2-1. And now we're going to have to rally in the bottom of the 11th. But we got to get there first. Runners at the corners. Two outs. Let's get out of this inning. No. Lorenzo Cain. Deep to right. One hop off the fence. Runners now at second and third. Oh, no. He's going to the plate. He's going to be out. So they make it 3-1. Try to get a little greedy. Could have been 4-1 right there. Buddy's cut down at the plate, and finally we get to bat, but find ourselves down two runs now and need to make it up. Ben Revere at the plate, he is going to single up the middle, so we've got speed on first base and needing two runs. This will bring the tying run up to the plate. So we look at the replay here, Ben Revere just hitting that right back up the middle of the diamond to center field. So coming to the plate, it's not Cameron Maven. We're pulling him back. And Mike Trout, who did have the day off, is going to grab a bat and pinch hit, as obviously this is a big spot here. If he could launch a two-run homer, we get a brand new ball game. He's done that 18 times so far this year. Let's see if he can make it number 19. He puts good wood to the baseball to right center field, but it is going to be caught as Revere's got to retreat to first base. So unfortunately, Mike Trout does not come through, and we got to try to get this done with somebody else at the plate. Two outs now. It's Pujols. He had his problems in the field, and, he didn't hit that ball very far. I think my son Coleman over here could have hit the ball farther than that. What do you think?
I could hit 12,000,000,106,000,120,000,176,000,059,000,000 more miles than that person did.
And that would be an MLB record if that were to happen. Coleman, that's for sure. Anyway, that game over with. We couldn't win it. We move on to the Bronx, Yankee Stadium. And we're trying to close down a game here with Bedrosian, our closer. 3-2 lead, Starlin Castro at the plate. He's going to roll one to second base. And just like that, we've got our win locked down. Bedrosian gets another save. Angels leave with the victory, 3-2. Let's go back to our calendar here in just a second and see what the next critical situation is going to be to arise for us. We win the first game in New York, but we got another one here. We are tied 5-5. Bottom of the 11th inning. Gary Sanchez up. He's 2-for-4. Okay, we've got a runner at first base. The pitch is not handled by the catcher. Pops away, and he's going to go ahead and slide headfirst into second base, putting himself in scoring position. That's a potential winning run, and it's a foul ball, or is it? No, they say he didn't touch it. Runner is coming around third trying to score. Throw is offline, and that is one of the weirder walk-offs you're ever going to see. I guess this will go down as a passed ball. Takes two bases, including home plate for the winning run. Let's take a look at the replay. I could have sworn this was fouled off, but I guess he does not make contact on it. It certainly got far away from the catcher. By the time he realizes what's going on, gets over here, and kind of double clutches as the runner decides to come all the way home. Throw not even close to the plate. I don't think it would have mattered. Chris Carter, your player of the game, gets some ribbing from his teammates right there. Yankees win the ball game in a wild finish, 6-5. So that one got away from us. Got to put it behind us here. We win another game in Yankee Stadium to win 2 out of 3. Then we win one and lose one to start this Boston series. So here we are with a 5-1 lead, and you got a chance for Danny Espinosa to hit his third home run of the game. Okay, well, let's see if we can pull it off. If you're going to do it, try to hit it towards the monster and over, right? Well, he gives it a try, but that thing is not going to clear the fence. He will not get his third home run of the game. Now we just want to lock this down and get the win. So player locking on Espinosa, as that is what they threw us into here afterwards. He will go ahead and hop throw over to first base to complete the double play. The Angels do win the game, and they win the series in Boston 2-1 remaining. A hot first place team here in the AL West. I believe we've got a 6 or 7 game lead in the West right now. Danny Espinosa, your player of the game, because he did hit 2 home runs prior to us taking control. Okay, so now interleague play with the Dodgers. We win the first 2 games. We lose the next one and then win to make it 3 out of 4. So now it's Seattle, division rival, and I believe the second place club in the West. We've got a tie game, chance to walk off with Pujols at the plate and Maven at first base. 2 outs, 1-1 pitch, and it is going to be grounded to short, and it's a fielder's choice. So we will not walk it off in the 9th. We're going to go to extra innings where we are going to see Mike Trout hitting in the 10th inning. 21 homers on the season now, and a chance to settle in the 10th.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. A drive to left. Get out of here. Get out of here. Gone. They win it. Santa Maria. solo home run here for Mike Trout. And with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get into extra innings, you're always looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
Mike Trout with the theatrics ends the ball game with the walk-off home run deep into the night, left center field. No doubt about it. And he sends the Angels fans home very, very happy on this night. Had to wait an extra inning for it to happen, but they get their walk-off and win the game 3-2. So a lot happening here as we press forward. We're getting close to the All-Star break. Trout now with, 22 homers on the season. Might see him in the Home Run Derby if he chooses to participate in about a week's time here, week and a half's time, when we get to the All-Star break. Come on back for more Angels baseball. We'll see you next time.